and welcome to Hard Talk. My name is Kofi Asante Mensah, the cream of creams. Have you for a minute thought about the world without film and movies? Well, how would the world be without movies to watch, etc.? I think it would be very uncomfortable. I love movies so much, and I'm sure you do love them as well. When was the last time you watched a good creative piece from the camp of a Ghanaian film director? Well, maybe it's been a while. Today we are talking about the film industry in this republic called Ghana. Once again, welcome. I have a special guest over here, and after the break, I'll introduce him to you. You welcome to Hard Talk, and we are live on Tumpani Television, and this is EP Urban Radio TV. Don't forget, you can download our mobile app when you visit the various Play Stores. You can download our mobile app, and it is 2C TV. We are also live on Go Television. Right back, then we'll talk more film industry.
Hi. When was the last time you read a good book or listened to a great poetry piece? Do you feel lazy doing either of them? Well, let me invite you to join me this and every Thursday right here on EPR Bangalore
and Tumpani TV from 5 to 5:30 p.m.
as I treat you to some good book reviews and great poetry pieces from some of your great poets and authors. You can be a part of the show as well. Just send me a DM, and like I always say, join me on my PYOB. Let's chill.
Do you have a story that is bugging your mind? Marriage issues, relationship issues, or social issues? You name it. Which you wish to share, but hide your identity? Worry no less. My story is just the right platform to help you find profound solutions to your problem. My name is Veronica Akomoksen, your host for my story.
This and every Monday, 8 to 8:45 p.m.
on EP Urban Radio TV.
And Tumpani TV.
EP Urban Radio TV.
For sponsorship. It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect
harmony.
Welcome back from the break. Please go ahead and like all our social media handles on YouTube. It is EP Radio TV everywhere. In exception of Instagram, which is EP Radio TV with the number 2. Continue and download our mobile app 2C TV. We are live on Tumpani Television and also Go TV. It's Hard Talk. My guest in the studio is the chairperson of the Film Classification Committee, Mr. Sukrit Safo. Sir, you're welcome to my side.
Thank you for having
me. It's good to have you.
Sure.
I hope you are doing good.
Yeah.
Let's talk about your committee. What is it about and what's your mandate?
The Film Classification Committee was set up under the Film Development and Classification Act 935,
okay,
which was passed in 2016. Our mandate, we derive our powers from the National Film Authority. The law says the National Film Authority shall set up the Film Classification Committee to classify and preview and classify audiovisual content. Now, when we talk of audiovisual content for public screening, what does it mean? Any audiovisual material that is coming public, i.e. TV, cinemas, internet, any public place that you are going to exhibit any audiovisual material, it must be classified.
Including social media?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's public screening. So within the jurisdiction of Ghana, if you are in Ghana and you are transmitting something to the public, it must be classified.
Wow. We'll get there. How we'll do that with especially social media? Okay. I'm sure you've devised a way already.
Sure.
Now let's enter into it. So you've been given the mandate. We have set up the committee. Yeah. When is work starting?
Well, from 15th June, we're opening our office at ATIC, Attic. There's yes. Accra Tourism Absolute Information way. Center, opposite sure. Afrikiko.
Afrikiko, yes.
Near the Jubilee House.
Yeah.
Okay, so you come to the Creative Art Council office. We have a desk in there to receive all the works. We are open. There will be somebody there to receive you and share information with you, inquiries and all that. You can have it from that office. Okay. But from 1st July, we expect TV channels especially to display the classification ratings on their screens. That means we will start monitoring and advise on what to do.
When you say classification rating,
yeah,
what are you talking about?
Okay, this is how our committee works.
Okay.
We have the preview committee. Any work, any audiovisual work that is presented to us, the committee will sit, watch the material, and advise the specific ratings that should be given to that film. We have U, that is Universal, that is PG, which is a parental guidance. We have 12, 15, 18, and NS.
Okay.
Good. Universal is a material that can be shown at all times.
Okay.
PG is a film that's something that can be shown.
Well, with a guide of the parents.
With a guide of the parents around. 12 is for audience above 12 years going. 15 for audience above 15 years, 18 for audience above 18. NS is not suitable for public exhibition. Not suitable for public exhibition.
Yes.
So these are the... Now, within that, we have a guidelines to... when it's, let's say, cinema, then whoever is admitting the audience in must make sure that whatever is on display at that material moment have the right audience.
And we are starting all of this from July 1.
Yes.
Wow.
Officially.
Officially.
Yeah.
Okay.
But we know the challenge, so we are roping
it gradually.
Gradually. We don't want to crash the system.
How are you taking time to push for people to understand more or less more education? For film directors and movie producers, including those in the media, some of us, TV, etc. How are you deliberately pushing for this education?
Okay. We are being strategic with our education and engagement with stakeholders. We are being strategic. Time gone past, what we will normally do is we will call a big meeting and just announce, but it has its challenge. I have had this experience where you invite stakeholders, they come and sit, and mostly when you invite them, like TV stations, they send one of their personnel who is idle, who is idle, to go and sit in that meeting for the records.
But not necessarily idle.
My bro,
okay.
Let's be honest.
Okay.
You don't get the decision makers to come and sit in these meetings. I have experience. I've been part of the copyright committee, anti-piracy committee. We've had several meetings. We've even organized workshops and things like that. And we know those who attend.
Yeah.
You don't get the decision makers to even participate. So what we do now is that, and even when they come to these meetings, they come and ask about funding. When are we receiving money? You see, the industry is suffering, and this is the quality, blah, blah, blah. Meanwhile, the main topic there don't get discussed. When they finish, they are asking for item 13. Now, even with the advantage of COVID, whereby we cannot organize people.
I love the way you put it.
Yes. We can't organize people strategically. We are visiting all the TV stations.
Oh, okay.
So far, we are left with about 60 stations to
in Accra.
In Accra.
Wow.
Yeah, one-on-one. And today, I am here in your station.
Absolutely.
So, I've had a conversation with your man.
The programs, already. Yeah?
Yeah. So, I think we are also covered. We are left with 7 now. And we know by Monday we will be able to cover that. And for me, that personal one-on-one interaction is even better. And I'm glad that
makes a lot of impact.
Yes, makes a lot of, because they get all the luxury of time to ask questions, and you also explain to them. And that is more fruitful than this mass. And you know, some of the people, even when they come, they have questions to ask, mm-hmm. but they are intimidated by even the crowd.
That's true.
It happens. Yeah. So they can ask. But when you meet them in the comfort of their zone, their comfort zone,
yeah.
then they can open up. That's true. And it's working.
That's true. You go to this errand yourself?
Yeah.
You do.
You can see my voice is even going off. I'm tired. Let me confess, I'm tired. But somebody must do it.
Wow. What are the preliminary challenges you are facing as you started going on this errand?
Well, logistics.
Okay.
The board has been set up fine, but we are struggling.
Mm.
But I have an eye on the goal. I don't want to be part of anything that will fail.
Mm.
So whatever I will do to make it work, I will do.
Wow.
If you read the law, it gives you all the accoutrements you need to fix the challenges of this industry.
Mm.
I've been part of the collapse of the industry. I contributed to it years ago, ignorantly. We were all ignorant years ago. So we did things that collapsed the industry.
Mm.
Now we are faced with this challenge of reviving it. So what can you do? Fortunately, I was part of the drafters of this law.
Mm.
And I know what the thinking that went into it. Most of the challenges we were facing and how we want it done. Vis-a-vis our constitution, our various regulations that governs all the industries. So we managed to weave like a maze around all these regulations. And we will get the results to fix the industry for Ghana to be the ultimate winner.
That's very true. Let's talk a little bit about the industry itself and the challenges confronting us. Even before we even do that, how did it feel when you were named or called for this huge responsibility?
Well, I remember some of the members of the former classification board were like, most as if they met and discussed, because they kept calling me one after the other, because I'm one individual in this country who has given them their biggest headaches. Every time I go to the classification with a film, they have a challenge. And it's not been easy handling me.
Mm.
So for me, it sounds like a curse on me. And you know the story of Saul, when he was persecuting Christians and later on he became Paul.
Yeah.
And I sit here and that's how I'm feeling.
Wow.
And I also look at the challenge, and I said it at the inauguration that I see some of my colleagues like Akwesi Abuaje, Halifa Sansado, Anoda Samuabe, Dunola, eating me up from my feet. And you know, when so you are being eaten from your feet, you don't die early. So when snakes want to swallow somebody, something, they take it from their
head
because they have compassion on the prey.
Mm.
But when you are being taken from the feet, it's not easy. You die slowly. And that is what I'm going through. The media, and I know you will get there soon. Absolutely. You will start bombarding me with all sorts of questions and trying to confuse me and all that. Sometimes I even forget that I'm wearing my spectacles.
Wow. Wow.
I'm still looking for it.
Are these friends being supportive?
Oh, yeah.
On the word go?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. They're supporting me by giving me the hard criticisms.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I like it. I like it.
Mm.
Yeah, because I also do it. That is what I do to people.
Absolutely. So, a bit about, we'll come to the film industry, a bit about when one defaults. If I fail and I air a cartoon or a film that has not been classified by this committee, this ABLE committee, what happens?
First and foremost, the law says that anybody who defaults, that the charges are 1,000 penalty units to 10,000 penalty units. And one penalty unit is 12 cities. So you calculate that by 1,000 or 10,000 or 4,000. It's within between 1,000 to 10,000. And the forfeiture of your equipment, whatever gadget you were using to perpetuate that crime or offense, should be confiscated. And you can go to jail for a term of between a year and 5 years.
Wow.
So this is what the law prescribes. Now, you ask what constitutes an offense under this law.
That's true.
If you exhibit a film or a product, and when I say a product here, it covers, I don't know if I've said it already, adverts, music videos, telenovelas, movies,
documentaries,
and live programs such as this one.
Okay.
Must also be classified. You ask yourself, how are you going to classify it?
Exactly.
You are aware, coming, you haven't given me a script. I know what we are coming to discuss.
Yeah.
But when you are designing this program, you know what program you are designing.
Yeah.
If you are coming to talk about adult-related topics, then you will bring your concept to us. We will assess it. We have a discussion with you.
So it's more the program synopsis or the concept.
Exactly.
Okay.
Then we will give you the ratings that for this particular program, the nature and the subject matter you discuss, it can go, it must go for this time belt. Yeah, that is how it goes. And when even the program is, let's say, classified universal, that means it can be shown at any time, and your guests come, it is up to you, the host, to make sure that he is operating or delivering within the boundaries. There are certain foul words or swear words that he may not use. If you look on, then you are the one that will be responsible. Now, every material that we will classify must be presented by the owner or the rights holder.
Okay.
If you don't have the rights for it, we cannot classify for you. Do you understand?
Yes.
So your channel, whatever, music video, adverts, movies, anything that you air, you must have the rights. If it's a foreign material, you must have the rights. If it's local, then the right owner must give you the license to screen it.
Okay.
You cannot screen without the owner, the rights. What we will normally, what we also do is that periodically we will request that you give us your playlist.
Okay.
All that you have shown within the month.
Okay.
As part of an institution that we are dealing with, you give us a report of your playlist every month. These are some of the checks and balances that we are putting in.
Okay. So if I go to shoot a movie or I have a product to present to the committee for classification and I bring it, how many months, days do I have to wait?
The law says that 21 days before your intended day of release, you must present it. If you don't present it by then, don't blame us. That will give us ample time for us
to classify it.
Okay. Now, when you present it, within 14 working days, we should be able to classify it for you.
Okay.
Now, don't panic, because we are not there to censor the movie. We are all the program, but we are only classifying it.
I was going to ask that. It's part of what I've written.
Yes, we are not a censorship board.
Board, okay.
We are only classifying it for you to tell you whether this can go for universal, that is U or PG or 12, 15, 18, or it's not suitable for screening.
Of course, but when you get to there, it's not suitable. Of course, then you are censoring.
No, we are not censoring.
Okay.
We are not censoring. We are only telling you that it's not suitable for screening, for public. If you want to go and do it in your bedroom,
an advice to it.
Exactly.
Maybe remove this from this.
Exactly.
Remove that from here.
That is why we are preview and classification. So when we preview, we can advise you. Even if the film is 12, and we see that no, the subject matter is of essence to even all classes.
Okay.
We can advise that maybe the degree of exposure of this scene is causing us to up the ratings, but it is something of essence to the society. So we want children of all ages to also see it. So can you please minimize or reduce?
Reduce it, okay.
Yeah. Now, when I say reduce it, pick a scene like nudity.
Okay.
It's one of the things that we look out for to up the ratings. But what degree of nudity are we talking of here? Depot.
Mm-hmm.
We all know Depot.
Yes.
It consists of naked young ladies.
Yes.
With their breasts on and you see their boobs, their butts and all that.
Yeah.
How do you classify that?
Mm.
Here we are. One of the key indicators is promoting of our cultural norms.
Yes.
So we must also educate our people about our culture. And here is the case that somebody has brought a documentary on Depot. What degree of this thing are you going to give it? When they are doing Depot in the Kroboland, they have kids. They all come and watch.
Yeah.
And that also inspired them to also live up to the expectation of society so that they can go through that puberty rite with pride. But if you present the material and we look at the extent of exposure and glorification of the naked bodies, quote unquote, then that will inform us the level or the extent of classification that we have to give it. It is how you treat the material. Let's say there's a ritual where a young lady or somebody, a young guy, is taken to the riverside for you get a lower rating than somebody who is giving it about 2 minutes. You understand?
Yeah.
So these are some of the things that we look out for and we also advise.
Mr. Zogesavo, let's talk a little bit about the Ghana film industry movie.
But don't forget, before we go there,
okay,
make sure
that
you have the rights before you bring it.
You are the owner.
Yes.
Or you have the rights.
From foreign movies, foreign music, adverts, whatever, make sure you have the rights. And that is the only way we can classify for you.
When we are back, we are going to talk more about our film industry. This is Hard Talk. And we are talking hard with the chair of the Film Classification Committee, Mr. Socrates Safo. We'll be right back.
Story that is bugging your mind, marriage issues, relationship issues, or social issues, you name it, which you wish to share but hide your identity. Worry the less. My story is just the right platform to help you find profound solutions to your problem. My name is Veronica Akomoksen, your host for My Story.
This and every Monday, 8 to 8:45 p.m.
on EP Urban Radio TV
and Tumpani TV.
EP Urban Radio TV.
For sponsorship.
It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony.
Hi. When was the last time you read a good book or listened to a great poetry piece?
Do you feel lazy doing either of them?
Well, let me invite you to join me this and every Thursday right here on EP Urban Radio
and Tumpani TV
from 5 to 5:30 p.m.
as I treat you to some good book reviews and great poetry pieces from some of your great poets and authors. You can be a part of the show as well. Just send me a DM and, like I always say, join me, your man PYOB. Let's chill.
Hello beautiful people, welcome to 30 Minutes with the Gram on EPTV. You know how we do it on the show. It's 100% fun, entertaining, trust me. You have 100% legit gossip on the show. It's about your favorite celebrities, both international celebrities and local celebrities. Don't forget to catch us live on EP Radio TV and also Tumpani TV. If you're a mobile person, ensure to download the mobile app, the 2C TV app, and watch us live on Tumpani TV.
This and every Tuesday at 12 p.m.
It's your girl, Honey Girl, the Queen of the South. Never forget, when fun gets deep enough, it can heal the world. See you.
For sponsorship.
Hi, everyone. My name is Nikki Samonas, and I want you to keep it locked on EP Radio TV and Tupan TV. Don't change the channel.
Yes, your boy Victor Pini and I'm hanging out with EP Urban Radio. Keep listening to EP Urban Radio, man. Don't touch that guy. If you don't love her, wait till you gain her, boss.
Keep listening to EP Radio. Don't touch that guy. It's all about EP Radio.
EP Radio.
And this is the new phase of radio. EP Radio.
Keep on listening to EP Urban Radio.
EP Urban Radio.
And you're listening to EP Radio, it's the new phase of radio.
Keep watching EP Urban Radio and Television.
You're watching and listening to EP Radio and TV. That's what's up.
It's Iwan the Lyrical Gunja representing on EP Urban Radio and TV. You see me, I said.
Stay tuned and keep listening to EP Radio.
EP Radio, we are there already. EP Radio, the radio of life. Oh, always on a tsunami ready to blow us away. Yay!
Hello, welcome back. This is Heart Talk with yours truly, the cream of creams, Kofi Asante Mensah. I'm still in session with Mr. Socrates Safo, the chairperson for the Film Classification Committee of the National Film Authority. We are talking about the industry. I want him to help me understand where Ghana fell short in the seemingly collapse of our film industry. Are we on the grounds? Are we dead as a country, our film industry?
Dead is relative.
Okay.
I've always said that it's dead. It's dead because it's not what it used to be. Mm. I know and I benefit and I enjoyed the film industry. But we are not at that level.
How did we die?
Because we were ignorant. If you have, let's say, a pet, I love dogs.
Okay.
Yeah, but I can't play with somebody's dog. You see, if you own a dog, it depends on how you manage it at home. It may die. But if you take good care of it, give it the right food, the right feeding, and it will grow and take good care of you. If you neglect your dog, one day it may turn and back at you.
Yeah.
So that is how we handle the industry. We were so ignorant on how we manage a film industry.
Mm.
A film industry. We were so ignorant. We didn't know how to handle a film industry. And that
have we been able to learn from our mistakes as a country?
Unfortunately, not everybody has learned. And some are committing more mistakes.
Mm.
It's like whilst a few are trying to put the sand back into the hole, there are a lot of people out there who have also digging it out. About 5 people are trying to close it, and about 100 people are digging the sand. So that is the struggle.
One.
But strategically, I think this.
Are you able to share probably one or two problems, major problems that confronted us as a country in the film industry?
There is no production or industry in the world that can survive without a market. If there is no market, the industry collapses. It first affects quality. Then it affects the numbers.
Mm-hmm.
And then the market will collapse. So we killed our market.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's all. We killed our market.
Once vibrant market, the Ghanaian.
Do you know how much the film industry was making? We were making over 200,000 CDs every Monday.
Wow.
At Opera Square alone.
Wow.
Over 200,000 cities. At Opera. When I say Opera, it's not a whole area.
Mm-hmm.
We have just 2-story buildings and there are about 8 shops. Within these 8 shops, from 4 a.m.
Mm.
to about 10 a.m., they make about 200,000 cities.
Wow.
Every Monday.
Not to talk of the other regions?
Not to talk of the other regions or Kumasi, KJTI, Doom and all those places. Just Opera alone. And this about 8 shops around Opera.
Mm.
That is what we killed.
Wow.
Now if you go there,
mm.
there are no shops. And everybody is looking at everybody and asking what happened.
Oh God.
Yeah, what happened?
This is so quite...
When you tell them what happened, those who understand will understand you, and there are those who also give some
excuses
that's from experience. You know that, no, these are no excuses. Because when you kill the market, how do you kill the market? You know, human beings have sense of sight, sense of hearing. These senses, you can't deny it.
Yeah.
Let's put off the lights here that you can't see anything. You start feeling uncomfortable.
Yeah.
If you stay here and you can't hear anything for, let's say, 1 hour, you start feeling uncomfortable. So these senses you can't deny. So we have a huge market in the housewife bracket. Housewives, that bracket, they were our about 99% of our market. We were
housewives.
Yeah, housewives. Right after taking care of the children, they go to school and they are home doing nothing. What would they do? They will put on TV. When they put on TV, there is nothing there.
So my sister is one of them.
So what will she do?
She watches everything.
Good. So he will go for
all the piano call videos. Yes. Is there. And now it came to, I think, DVDs.
Yes.
She was buying all of them.
Buying. Why was she buying?
She was home enjoying watching movies.
Sense of sight.
Jacko movies, etc.
Yes. But what did we do? We start giving it to the same TV sets for free.
Mm.
So if you go to the market and buy the film, you come home to watch and you put on the TV and the film is being screened.
You won't.
How will you feel? You feel so stupid for spending money to buy this.
The market.
Sometimes starts. Even what you've bought is on TV. Do you understand?
But why did producers of such movies?
That is the stupid part of our.
Why did they do that?
We were stupid, my brother.
Oh my God.
Ignorance. That's why we didn't know how to manage a film industry. Television is an industry on its own.
Yeah.
If you want to go into that field as a businessman, you must understand. Music has its own dynamics. If you don't understand, you will spend all your money there and you'll get nothing. We didn't know how to manage a movie industry. Let me tell you, if I say I'm part of those who killed it, yes. I'm one of those who were making noise that TV should show Ghanaian movies.
Really?
Yes. And we push. I was one of the people who gave our movie to TV stations first. Ghost Years, I remember. They were still showing. Video theaters were coming for the film. And
What was your motivation? Let's enter into it small.
Motivation. Ignorance.
Wow.
We were so ignorant. Because at that time, you had some, how do you call them, video centers who were coming for the films to show at least every week. When in those days, you get some about 500,000.
We had a lot of them, video centers.
Yes.
Video centers.
And they were coming
for gate fee for you to come in, come and watch.
So stupid, we felt like, sorry for my language.
That's okay.
But let me, that's the thing.
I understand.
We took the film and gave it to GTV that they should show.
How?
And they gave us 2 million cedis. Meanwhile, that 2 million cedis, within 3 months, we could have made the 2 million.
When was this?
That was, forgotten the years, but it was in the 90s.
Wow.
We went to lobby that they should show on TV. I remember one of their directors there, he's late now. We were in Burkina Faso, Fespaco, and he said, I don't understand why you want to show your films on TV. We said, no, you are showing foreign content. Foreign, no, we also have films here. And we gave it to them and they showed. That week, those who were coming for the film small, they stopped coming because everybody has seen it. We didn't learn our lesson from them. But you see, it feels so good to drive around sometimes when you see those who show TV, who put on their television set by the roadside, and people have gathered and they are watching your movie.
You feel
so good. Feel so good.
Probably that's the motivation.
Well, but that is stupidity, sorry.
Yeah.
Because that film, every 5 years, you have new generation. So
and
all you need
to
do,
them.
It will be new to them. So you repackage the film, redesign the poster, and bring it again
back to market,
and you make more money than how much a TV station will give you.
So where did you learn this from? Who taught you this? That go.
No, but you see, today, even a film like Hot Fork, everybody is talking of Hot Fork.
Yes.
But I'm telling you, 90% of the people who are talking about Hot Fork haven't seen it.
It's true.
So if I should advertise again,
people will still watch. Yeah.
Want to watch.
And buy.
And I'll make more money. Every 5 years, a film will have a new life.
It's true.
Every 5 years. So you ask yourself, what is the motivation in giving it to TV? And you know, sometimes you should check the agreements.
Yes.
Timeless. They just give it to them and TV station can show it at any time.
Anytime.
Any number of times and for whatever years. Because they don't know the value of the product. So that is why I said, if five people are closing the hole and you have about 100 people digging the sand out, what can you do? So if a few people realize that, what you are saying is true, let's stop. And we take our film to the market. And you have about 100 film producers line up and begging TV stations to show their films for 200 Ghana cedis. You understand? And it's not as if when they take it there, they give them to the 200 Ghana cedis. No, it's on credit. Yes. And some of them are paid on Momo, like, today take 50. And then they will call, and then my...
What?
Oh, yeah, that is a fact.
On Momo. And you still queue?
Yeah.
Wait till the TV station takes you?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
If not stupidity, what is it? Meanwhile, if we withdraw all the films from the TV channels, the sense of sight that no human being can deny will push them to go and buy, because when we are playing the advert, part one, and Kojo Dixon is narrating the story, and you are sitting at home and you put on the TV
and it's not showing on your television screen,
you will go and buy, and the producer will make more money.
Oh, God.
And you have somebody, a young boy who have not experienced what I have experienced, will come and argue with me that, what you are saying, you see, we passed that stage. When did we pass that stage? Technology is something that you determine when it eats you up.
That's true.
Do you understand? It's like the hangman's rope, and you are in control.
Yeah.
You decide when you push the table.
That's true.
Is there fine? They've put the rope on your neck, and you are standing on the table.
Yeah.
You decide when you push it. Yeah. So, technology is coming, yes, but if I say no, I am not operating on this level. I am here. You have no choice than to come there. Do you understand?
Yeah.
If the films are not on TV, you put on your TV and I'm advertising the movie. And you are telling me that now you see television is all over television, social media, streaming. We are streaming and getting nothing. A population of about 3 million. Let's say we want just 100,000 people to buy, which we were comfortably selling. At even 5 cedis, that gives you how much? 500,000 cedis per movie. Do you understand?
If you stream...
Tell me anybody who have made about 100,000 from streaming. Yet you get somebody to tell you that, can't it yourself? When is that it? Yes, there is a new avenue. Yes, it's there. But people still have their decks at home. They've only taken the decks and they are not watching with the decks because we have given the films to TV. So they don't have any use for the deck again.
Yeah. Gathering dust.
And we are saying that no, people have stopped using. No, we told them to stop. So if we say they should plug it back, they will. Well, you understand?
Yeah.
If you put on the TV and you are not seeing what
you wish to see.
Why are people still paying for channels that are showing the Premier League? Meanwhile, they have TV.
That's true.
People, very soon you go to companies and you see people queue there paying to watch the Premier League. Because that is the only channel you can find the Premier League.
That's true. And still is there.
It's still the TV is there at home, fine. But you can watch any other match. But Premier League, no, this is the only area.
That's true.
and people are still paying. And
you know, there's technology.
There's technology, fine. So this same technology is here, but my product, my film, Hot Fork, if you want to watch, you buy it. Your film, you buy it. All the filmmakers are saying that come and buy before you can watch. And you have the deck there, and we have it on our DVD. It's not a crime. You won't be taken to The Hague to be convicted. It doesn't make you an idiot. Yes, there's technology, fine, there's streaming. But we have tried all this and it's not working. We are not making the numbers. But you have people, somebody who thinks that he's IT inclined and will make you look so like you dear, you don't know the time. Hello. I determine the time. I decide when to cross over. Until we are ready. Right now, even pen drives, we are not secured with pen drives. We are not. Years ago, we said Nigerian films were taking over.
Yeah.
Do you know what was actually happening?
No.
Okay. We were producing or releasing Ghanaian films on Pure Monco when people were buying the DVD players. And the Nigerian films were coming on the CDs.
Okay.
Until we did.
Okay.
But I think so far, government has done enough for us.
Okay.
In the creative arts. What is left is for us to do what is needful to get what we need. If you ask me, so far, what I just narrated to you, we were making money. If I shoot a movie and I sell 100,000 copies and I make about 500,000 and I pay everybody around, what do I need government for? How much can government give me? And this one, it is me producing the film and putting it on the market and selling. Now, I have killed the market and I'm crying on government for government to do what? If government gives me money, I will shoot the movie and I'll still lose because there's nowhere to sell it. You understand? Talk of theaters where we show these movies.
Yes.
Whilst we are showing the movie for free on TV, the theaters are there. And we say government should build theaters. Fine. You know what? I had an investor who was ready to invest in the theaters we promised as a government. And there was a conversation. And they start asking for the numbers. And it looks like it's bad investment for them. Because what are the numbers? We visit some of the cinema halls. We check the numbers, the attendance. And I remember we went to one of the cinema halls. And I said, is that all the people? I said, oh, yeah. But you see, today, I said, okay, let's come tomorrow. We went and I said, oh, weekends, that's when you have the people. He said, oh, so only weekends? So the other days, where are the people? But I know where the people are. The people are sitting at home enjoying the thing on TV. Years ago, you go to Ghana Films and throughout the week, even if you don't get patronage, you have half of the seats covered, which make good business. So if somebody should invest in theaters, he knows the people will come. But here's the case that the product that we should bring there is on TV for free. So if you invest there, how will you make your money back? If government should give money, as we speak, government through GTA has given some producers money.
Yeah.
They are shooting. But the question I keep asking myself is, how are they going to pay back? Because I know there is no market. How are they going to pay back? And as you try to fix it, try to conscientize them that, look, it will take just a day to revive this dead thing, just one day, for us all to decide that, look, henceforth, we are not giving our films to TV. We were in Kumasi. We had a workshop with them. In those days, I was with an institution where we were supporting producers. So we had a meeting with them to tell them that, look, we are giving you money to shoot. Don't take your films to TV. I was at a TV station where I support, in a way. I was there when I saw the MC for the day come with this Ghana Must Go bag full of movies.
Oh my God.
the MC for the workshop we had, where we all agreed that yes, giving the films to the TV stations is not the right thing. The MC, the one who was MC,
the master of the ceremony, brought a bag full of films
from, he's collected it from, and his job is that he collect it from them and then give you a figure, a rate, then he will come and up it to the TV station.
Wow.
Yeah.
Mr. Safo, who would be that messiah finally to rekindle this industry for us? I quite remember when I met you with Lillian at your office, at not to talk about or shift the focus of this interview, at Xylophone, when you were working over there, I saw certain revival of the industry when we're going to use models to more or less sell CDs and all of that.
Yeah.
Who is that messiah who can come in to revive this industry?
You.
Oh my God. That's quite on the lighter side.
Oh, come on, you can do it. You can do it. You can do it. You can do it. Why? You don't believe you can do it?
I'm not coming out believing.
Yeah, you can do it. Mm. At least, if you are intelligent, you can easily do it. Mm. Yeah.
What will be your final message to our colleagues? I was going to ask your opinion on nudity, our music videos, etc. But because of time, we have to leave it here. Maybe some few final comments to what we've discussed about the classification committee, our industry, falling industry, how we would have to rekindle and rejuvenate it.
Final word. I don't have any final word.
Wow.
I'm thinking, but I don't know what the final word should be. But I only advise that let nobody fall foul of the law.
Mm.
You understand? Don't try. Because the law will work.
Mm.
Yes, I know people have dared me that, oh, come on, way. 9 day wonder, Ochi, Nkusia guy, Hura Bejo. But he who is down fears no fall.
Mm.
So I'll prefer to die with you than die alone. So that when we get to the land of the ancestors, we will enjoy. I'll have a partner. And I say, we die together.
But maybe this will be the final. How has COVID impacted on the film industry? And how is the support from government also going? Just in a minute.
Well, COVID, you know, is a new thing.
Yeah.
And it hit us like unexpectedly. So governments have been thinking of an ingenious way to do things. Mm-hmm. There's no blueprint as to how to handle this. This is something new. So far, I think government is finding a way. So there's been a stimulus package to the industry players, and I know some of them are applying. But my fear is
how they will pay back.
It's not about, yes, but they will not be able to pay back because there is no market. The market is not something that we need to bring from mass. The market is when you and I, one day, I keep saying, it will just take one day, we all decide. Just like we have decided that from 1st July, TV stations must display their ratings. Fine. If you are coming to classify a movie, you need to be the right owner. If you come and we don't classify for you because you are not the right owner, what can you do?
Mm.
You need to get the rights. If you don't get the rights from outside, there are 1,001 contents in Ghana. Contact the content producers. Okay. They will give you 1,001. Stop pirating.
It's a pleasure having you.
Thank you.
His name is Mr. Sokri Safo, the chair for the Film Classification Committee. I've been in session with. My name is Kofi Asante Mensah. Thank you so much for being there for us. And this has been Hard Talk on Tumpane TV and EP Radio Television. Thank you once again. Like I used to say, the chameleon changes color to match the earth. But the earth never changes color.
Who is the chameleon here?
Well... Well, which one are you? Are you a chameleon or you are the earth? I love to be the earth. God bless you.
They are babblers, noisemakers, and
You see, people have been outwitted in their minds. Follow them. Majority of them, I'm sorry to say on air that they've been fooled.
Thank you.